first start off by introducing those individuals that have toured with me for quite some while. My daughter, Amanda, my grandbaby, Alyssa, and the apple of my eye, my wife, Loretta. Let me start off by saying, for over 35 years, I've had the opportunity to work, to share, and to live in this great community. I've touched the lives of many citizens. I've been fortunate enough to be with them on the sunshiny days, during graduations, birthday parties, and babies being born. I've been able to be with those families on their dog days, when sickness occurred, when they had a loss of a loved one, loss of employment. But whether it was through the good days or whether it was through the bad days, it has helped me to develop a heart of a servant. And that's really why we're here today. I have listened to the citizens of this great city as they have asked and talked about their drainage, talked about unemployment, talked about the school district. I have listened to the business owners, small and large, as they talked about the loss of population. They was concerned about the increase in our crime rate. But I stand here today to tell you that these issues and others, we can address them if we will be willing to accept change. All right. It is clear to me and to many other citizens of this great city, we must embrace change. I want to go on record today to say we cannot change our condition by merely changing Cherry Street. We can't change it by merely changing Main Street. We must change our condition from the east side of this great city, clear over to the west side, to embrace the Loop area. We must change this city from the south side of Watson Chapel, clean across the bridge to the rich soil of UAPB, if we're really gonna make a change. We can do this if we do it together. I'm optimistic about the benefits we will share as a result of our community working together once we embrace change. We can achieve our goals when we embrace change. I stand ready today to lead this great city in this change. The knowledge I have of the challenge that's before us and the call to change that is within us will make this city and all of us will be a catalyst of growth, unity, prosperity in our own community. It is clear now, it is time for us to tell our children they no longer have to leave this great city to be employed. It's time for us to tell our children, my grandbaby took me to Little Rock, to the trampoline park, to Urban Air. It's a sad day when our city, we don't have a movie theater. We must take stands and change immediately. So I'm here today saying to you, join me, but it's gonna take all of us together to change it. That's why I say to you today, I stand here to announce to you and others that I am a candidate for the mayor of this great city of Pine Bluff. want to say three things and we'll be through because I said we'll be short. I want to first tell you about my pledge to the community. I pledge that we're going to enhance public safety. We don't have time today to talk about all the details, but we're going to make it right. We're going to deal with a citywide street and drainage initiative. Everywhere I go, people are talking about this drainage problem. But the truth to be told, back when I was a lieutenant and a sergeant at the police department, they was talking about drainage. And we have not yet started to handle that problem. We will never finish it if we don't start it. So we must do that. I expect the city to hire an economic development specialist. Ladies and gentlemen, let me say to you, if you are not at the table at the first meeting, you won't get the fruit that you so rightfully deserve. So if we hire our own economic specialist, that's going to help keep our business here and recruit other business to come here. It's a must. We must have a strong youth initiative. And there's a two phase of that. We have some children that did not have what others had, and they strayed away. But we must embrace that, and we must have a program to help them. We have some children that have walked the straight line, and we must have programs that enhance them as well. So it's a two-phase initiative that we would do with our youth. We must have a redevelopment of home strategy. Every house that has a good foundation should not be torn down. Everybody cannot afford a $100,000 home. So we can take some of these homes and redevelop them and let citizens of Pine Bluff accept and realize the American dream of owning their own home. And then we must develop a strong relationship with our school district. I know the city can't mandate anything with our school district, but those are our babies. Those are our children. And we must ask them to do all they can to help our children out. The next thing I want to say to you, all you heard today, even if you elect me mayor, would mean nothing if the council do not catch a hold of the vision. It would mean nothing if we start fighting about the plan. It would mean nothing if we cannot embrace change. So I say to you today, not only I'm asking for your vote and your support, I need you to say it to the council that they too must embrace change. The last thing I'm going to leave you with, some of you all would leave here tonight and you would ask the question, why now? You would ask the question that he was once the chief of police. Your question would be, Mayor Washington hired him. So let me answer that for you before you leave. Over a year and a half ago, I had a conversation with our now Mayor Washington. She said to me, Chief, God told me to run one time, and then I was going to go back into retirement. I said to the mayor, I said, Mayor, don't tell anybody else that, because you may change your mind. She said, no, it's not a mind-changing issue. It's what God told me to do one time. After she told me that, some months later, I texted the mayor. I said, Mayor, I'm running for third ward alderman. Being that you said to me you're only going to be a one-term mayor, if I'm blessed enough and God allowed me to be third ward alderman, I'll have 2 years under your leadership. And when you leave, I'll be in a position to run for mayor. That was my conversation. That was my text message to Mayor Washington. So when you ask why now, because I do believe Mayor Washington is a God-fearing woman, and she would do what God told her to do. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Ivan Whitfield. I'm a candidate for mayor, and I'll prove this message.